So today we will be taking another field in our form. Okay, so because form is going to have more than one field and we have to validate all of them. So we are going to take a new field named pin code. Okay, so we will be validating pin code along with the name. The user has entered the name and then he has to also enter the pin code. So let's go to Composer now. So if you remember clearly, whenever we enter a pin code, okay, there are some rules which we have to follow. So we want those rules to be applied in our form also. Like the validation which we will apply on these fields are: user should not keep the field empty. Second one, only numbers are allowed, characters are not allowed. And third one, the pin code should be 6 digits long. Okay, this is for India. So we have to keep this in mind that he should not keep the field empty. Only numbers are allowed and only 6 digits are allowed. And if any of the validation is violated, okay, we are going to edit these three conditions. If any of the three is violated, the user will be displayed an alert message following the steps given to create such a validation. So now we'll follow the following steps which are given here to create such kind of validation. Okay, so this is the code here given, the simple code for validation. And so first of all, before we start with the coding, okay, first we need to design the element in our form. Okay, so I will go and we'll see whether the form is there or not. Okay, report form is, yes, it is available. I click on browse and I can see how the validation is working. Yes. Okay, so that is working now. So if I go to the source, I can see different things. I just want to modify this message. Okay, don't leave. I will just modify it to give it a more clear answer. Name field empty. Okay. So now he knows that he has to fill the name. Okay, so this we have completed in the previously. Okay, so today first I will take the pin code field. So I have to just write pin code header here and I'll follow the basic steps. Go to form field. I need a text box. I will write the name pin code. Click OK. So now the box is created. Now I just have to define different validation rules. So now, as you already know, we have to check the text box, okay? What is written in the box? So we know the procedure from the yesterday's class that we have to first define a variable in which we will store the value which is stored in the text box so that we can check with the if condition. So here, after this curly bracket gets over, okay? So now I have to again write the conditions here. But first I will define the variable here. So we can define the variable here as y. So now this variable y is equal to document, that is my current object, demo1, that is my current form. Then the name of my element, that is pin code. I hope you all know this, how we are going through this. And at the end, I write the value. Sorry. So now this statement, it is going to get the content of the pin code text box and assign it to the variable y. Okay. So now we have done that step successfully. Now, what is our next step? Our next step is to check whether this y is empty or not, whether y is having numerical value or not, or whether y is having 6 digits or not. Okay. So we'll go and see, have a look at the textbook, what the textbook says now. Okay, so here, this is the block which we have to write, okay, to get our PIN code validated properly. So here, if you see, this is similar to the earlier validated option. Okay, so we will check first that whether it is empty or not. Then we have this OR operator. Okay, OR means it is going to check whether this is true or this is true or this is true or this is true. So if any one of these all options are true, then the if condition stands true. We have two types of condition operators here. Okay, logical operators, you can see logical operators, we can say them, that is AND operator and OR operators. Okay, so AND means all the conditions has to be true, so then the overall condition becomes true. Whereas for OR operator, if any given condition is true, then the whole condition becomes true. So here, if this is true or this is true or this is true or this is true, then also it is true. If this is false, this is false, this is false, but if this is true, then also this if condition becomes true. So it is like checking for multiple options here. So first is we have to check whether it is blank. Then we have to check this with this is NAN. This is something new for all of you. It is nothing but a inbuilt function. Okay. It is an inbuilt function of JavaScript. And its full form is not a number. Is not a number. Okay. So it is one of the most commonly used numeric function. This function determines whether the value is not a number. It returns true if the value is not a number and false if the value is a number. Okay, you got it clear? So it is going to return true if it is not a number and it is going to return false if it is actually a number. So what here we are checking is it not a number? And in the bracket, we define the variable whose value will be checked, whether it is not a number or not. So here in our case, if it is not a number, then we will issue the message by please enter the PIN code properly. Okay. So that is how this is going to work. Then we have a property. Okay. Length property, just like how we have this value property. So y dot length is greater than 6. We will check whether the length is greater than 6 or not. If it is greater than 6, then we have to alert him by please enter the PIN code properly because PIN code needs to be 6 digit. And next condition is whether it is less than 6. So what will happen if it is greater than 6 and less than 6? In that case, it will show error. But when it is exactly 6, it will go on. Okay. Then the if statement becomes false and this all messages will not be shown to the user. So now we'll implement this in our coding and see how it goes on. So I'm going to write if. If condition here. If y is double equal to empty space or y is not a number or y's length is less than greater than 6 or y's length is less than 6. So we are checking both the conditions because we want exactly 6 digits. Then we close this bracket. So if this condition is true or any of the conditions which we have written here are true, we will write an alert message. We will write an alert message, and this message can be anything which you want the user to know. So I will write here, please write the correct PIN code. Now the message is given, but after the message, we also know we have to guide the user to the actual box where he has to enter the details. So that can be done using this line document, that is the current page, demo one, that is the current form, and in that the particular text box, that is pin C capital pin code dot focus method. So this is going to focus the box and we will get a highlighted color there. And then I want to stop the form to go forward. And I end the if statement here. So yeah, I have written all the conditions and we'll see whether this is working properly or not. Go to the browse button. Don't leave the name field empty. Okay. So I'll write here my name and I'll try to submit again. So now it is detecting my code and it is mentioning this error message. Please write the code, correct pin code. Okay. So let me see. You can see the focus is also there. The blue color border is glowing. So that means the focus is also there. And now I will write the pin code here. So suppose I make a mistake. Okay. I write something in alphabetical way here. So it is not going to accept it. Okay. So I now know that I don't have to enter numerical values, alphabetical values. I have to enter numerical values. So I write 3962 1010 by mistake. And if I click on submit, it is again going to stop me. So I have to write the correct pin code. So I will again go and again, I forget to enter one number and I click on submit. Again, it is showing me an error. So what is happening? It is not accepting. It is not accepting less than 6 and it is not accepting something which is more than 6. So that is what we want with our form. Okay. So I will write here 396210 and then I click on submit and there is no more the error shown to me. So we can say that now this is properly working. Okay. So I got one question, very nice question, that sir, can we just not write here the complete name that is not a number? Actually, we cannot write it because this is an inbuilt JavaScript function. So JavaScript developers have already defined this in this way. So we already know it, JavaScript is case sensitive. Also, the inbuilt functions name are given to us. So we have to use them as it is. We cannot modify them. Also, you have to take very much precaution to see that N is capital, A is small, and N is again capital. So exactly, we have to write in that same format in same way. Then only this code is going to work. Now, what happens once you start to write the code, okay? Once you start to design the form, the number one mistake that many students do is they design the form all together and they start to do the coding all together. And then what happens in case there is an error in any one particular code of any particular text box or you can say any other element, then they are not able to find out it. So a better way would be to go step by step, just like how we are doing here. We defined the name element first and we executed the validation code for it. So once it was validated and we now know that the name field is working perfectly, then we can move on to the next element. So now if the next element doesn't work, we are sure that the issue is only with something new which we have done, not the earlier code. So it saves our effort of going through again all the code and wasting so much of time. Okay, so this is a strategy which you can use, that you can go step by step, take one element and validate them along the way. So like this way, you will come to know which part of the code is giving you trouble. So like this, I have done for pin code. Now I can do similarly for phone number also, because phone number also will have the almost same conditions. Only the thing will change, that is the length of the mobile number. So now I can take a field that is phone number and I can insert field and it will be phone number You see now why this name is very important, because this name is linked with our JavaScript validation code. So we have to give the proper naming also here. Now I go here. I define again a new variable. Okay, so you can save a lot of time. You have to do some smart works. That is, you can copy paste all these things. I can just copy it. I can just paste it here. I have to just modify this thing. Instead of pin code, I am going to write the new text box name. It is phone number. Okay, now this thing is also same for me. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to click and select all this. Okay, this is only for the advanced users who are able to understand what changes they have to do. Okay, for the normal students, I will request you type it all along, and by that typing, you'll also remember the code properly. So here I will just modify. I will make this Z because everything else is same. This will help me to save a lot of time, and also the code is already correct, so there are less chances of error. And I will modify here also. Here also it will is going to be phone number. And I'll save this now. And we'll go to the browser now. You see how this JavaScript code is working. It doesn't give us the message altogether. Why? Because it is executing line by line. Okay, so the first thing, the first validation is of name. So therefore the message is of name appearing first. Okay, this is how we have to design it. Pin code properly. Okay, 396210. Click on submit. Okay, I did one small mistake here while copying pasting. This was intentional. This was intentional to make you all realize that while copying pasting, we will do some other error. So what error we have done? We have not updated the error message. So we'll go back again to the source and we'll modify the error here. Write the correct phone number. Okay. And I'm going to check my text box now, the phone number text box. Okay, now the error message is correct. The focus is correct. I write a text value. It is not going to accept it. I have to delete it again. And I write some numerical values here, which is more than 10, it is not going to accept. Less than 10, it is not going to accept. And exactly 10, no more error. So this is how we are going to work with those fields which have numerical value and conditions and validations.
Sir.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, in the source code, why did we write phone number N capital?
Yeah, this is because we are following, I am actually following a naming convention here, a naming strategy, which is known as camel case. What happens in this camel case, because the codes are all together, it becomes very hard to identify the name. So a strategy is developed, which is known as camel case, wherein just like camel, okay, you see its hump is there. So therefore we use the second word of the whole word, okay, the second important word, first character has to be capital. So it becomes easy to see it clearly among all the code. If we just make it a smaller end, then it becomes very hard to identify and read what exactly that particular term is. So therefore we add a capital letter there, and some people also make this also capital, so it becomes more easy. So this is something which coders do normally to make the code visibility more easier for the eyes and easier to debug also. Like once there is an error and you have to find out the error, that times it becomes more easier to see and understand the code. That is the only reason here. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I think that's it for today. This only one important validation we have done, and this is going to be very important for your examinations also, because most probably this will be there in your practicals, how to validate a PIN code or a phone number. Okay, I hope you all understood. And if there was some difficulty, you can go back again on YouTube and see this video again. The last year videos are also there. This year's video will also be there available to you. Okay, so you can go there and see it again and again as per your convenience.